Appalachian State is in the WBI championship game, and they're taking on the North Texas Mean Green. I'm Joshua Kornmeyer alongside Appalachian State head coach Angel Elderkin. Coach, your team just got to 21 wins, have won three straight to get to this championship game. Reflect on the past several weeks, especially in the month of March, and how your team has elevated their level of play.
Yeah, it's been really awesome to watch their focus throughout this month in terms of just their execution, their ability to just continue to come in. And, you know, I was saying it the other day, we're at practice like 130, and we still have players that are staying around extra to get free throws. They're staying around extra to get shots up. And it's pretty amazing to see, because at this time of the year, it's easy to check out. And our team has checked in. They've had a purpose. They've had a vision. And they just continue to keep executing down the stretch and giving us 40 more minutes.
Like you said, it is a long season. And now you're in the month of April. Your team has checked in, like you said, but just talk about how they've embraced this moment, especially playing here at home with the fans in the crowd.
Yeah, I think it was huge. You know, last week I found out if we would have won on Saturday, we were hosting the championship game, and the administration said, you know, we don't want to put anything, you know, not putting one thing in front of the other. And I said, well, you know, it's a really good carrot to dangle to our team. And so I had told them, like, we win on Saturday, we play on our home court for a championship, and that really excited them. That gave them a little bit momentum too, to be able to stay at home. And then when you have a fan base that came out like the way they did on Wednesday before the game, whatever nerves we were feeling on Saturday, I said, look at this, guys, this is awesome. And they were just so excited and proud.
With the big crowd that expected to come out here again today, it's imperative that your team gets out to a fast start. And we know North Texas, they've really done well in the first quarter. Do you think the momentum of the crowd and just the overall feeling is going to jumpstart this team?
I hope so. We've really started well throughout the tournament, and that's been something that's been able to give us a little bit of energy. We know that they do the same, and, you know, it's a championship game. It's going to be a heightened atmosphere. You know, there could be some nerves early, but my hope is that our team will continue to attack the way that they have been in that first four-minute segment.
In the last several games, you've relied heavily on the starters. Most of them have played 30-plus minutes the last couple of games. Do you envision the same type of game here today, just going with the starters and leaning on them?
Yeah, I mean, that's the plan, but I think I know that we've been fortunate to not really deal with a lot of foul trouble. North Texas does a really good job in the paint, attacking the post. They could get us in foul trouble, so we will have to probably go to our bench. I'd like to play our bench more. They don't pressure. I think sometimes when we go to our bench, teams amp up the pressure, and then we turn over. We have empty possessions, but our bench has continued to prepare every day with us, and so we kind of, it's not about getting ready. It's about staying ready. They will be ready when their number's called today.
It's no secret that Pree Stanley and Maddie Story played extremely well in the month of March. What are you expecting from them here again today, and maybe a couple of your other players as well?
For Pri and Maddie, I'm expecting nothing but the best from them. They understand. They've done a great job of just being aggressive, attacking. They're in sync. They're playing their best basketball, and that's going to be no different today. I think Bailey's been doing a great job of rebounding the ball, wanting the ball in the paint. Ashley's been running. I mean, I can't say enough. I think with our last two games, I mean, I know maybe it wasn't the last one. The Marshall was the first time we had all five starters in double figures, and then we almost had all five. They're playing their best basketball, and I expect that today.
Of course, North Texas is very good defensively, and when they get going offensively, they're tough to beat as well. What's really the focus other than the first quarter, other than the rebounding? Is there one big focus that you want your team to look at?
You know, we've put an emphasis on, like, their high-alert players. We've put an emphasis on their post-game. Throughout the tournament, we've been faced with some really good three-point shooters, and we don't have that in North Texas. That's not their specialty. But they're in the pace of play. They're a good defensive team because they take so much time on offense to execute. So we've got to make sure that when we get stops, we're going to force them to get up and down with us and play at the pace that we need to. Anytime a team plays at a pace like a Campbell, like an Asheville, it's, you know, a little nerve-wracking for us. We don't want a 50-50 game. In their last three wins, they've scored 56 points.
Your team, of course, coming in, last game of the season, win or lose. What's their mentality? What was the feeling during the walkthrough here today?
There's a feeling of excitement that I'm really happy for them. They're loose. I think we got to continue. I think as coaches, we know what could hurt us today. We really have a full grasp of that, but we're not letting our kids know. Our kids' confidence is at a high level. We want to keep them loose. We want to keep them happy. We want to keep them in the moment, and we want to keep them talking about winning a championship.
And lastly, any final thoughts before today's game?
you know, win or lose, this game's not going to define what this team has done this season. This team has left their mark, they've left their legacy, and they've left one of the strongest foundations for us to really turn this App State women's basketball program around. So I'm proud of them, regardless of what happens today in our last 40 minutes.
Thank you, Coach, and good luck in today's game.
Thank you.